So the next topic that we're going to discuss is the cavity resonator. Cavity resonator. So I've placed or put a cave in this slide. So in just to give you a little intuition of cavity resonator. So in this place, echo is very eminent or very distinguishable when you are in this kind of place, especially if you are emitting a high frequency of sound, that the probability of chances of getting reflected, since you're producing a high frequency sound. So and somehow, it has similarity with our cavity resonator.
Happy, the signal's still jumping around.
The girders are just steel alloy. They shouldn't be interfering with the signal.
Yep, well, I'm down here, and I'm telling you, I can't get a proper signal.
Calm down, I'm trying to find an answer.
Excuse me, I am perfectly calm.
Yeah, you sound perfectly calm.
Enough. This thing's echoing in my ear from you two acting like children. Get it together.
Echo. Wait, that's it, Walt. There's got to be a hollow space located in the hall somewhere that's causing the signal to bounce around like an echo whenever the boat swells. Yes, there should be a crawl space above you, 8, maybe 10 feet up.
So we should ask ourselves why we should study the cavity resonator, or why we should know it as an engineer. Because cavities such as this have extremely high Q. Remember that the Q is the quality factor. So as high as 30,000, for this reason, they are commonly used to create a resonant circuits and filter at microwave frequencies. So microwave oscillator, amplifiers, and bandpass filters are the common purpose or application of this resonator. So just to give you a brief review of IQ, so meaning when you the body plot somehow like this, it's the in the latter slide I will give you a much clearer picture of this high quality factor. Okay. So let's define what is cavity resonator. So a cavity resonator is a waveguide-like device that acts as a high Q parallel resonant circuit. So this cavity resonator originates from our discussion rectangular waveguide. Okay? Because as you remember, this one looks rectangular waveguide. It's just that this one, and even this one, and also this one is close. This is a close, and so that's the origination of this cavity resonator. It comes from the rectangular waveguide. So the analysis of fields in cavity requires the solution of the full three-dimensional wave equation with the required boundary condition. So this is one of the example of cavity resonator. So again, I would like to emphasize this closed ended. This one. So just give me a few minutes. I will prepare the simulation of what it really happens in the cavity resonator. Okay, so take a look at the simulation. Okay, so we have coordinate of J and coordinate of K. That symbolizes that we are simulating it in a 3D manner. You could visualize that J would be the top view and the K would be the side view. Pay attention to the going back and forth of the electromagnetic. So basically, that is the visual representation of this cavity resonator. Okay, so let's just go in a loop. That's how cavity resonator. Okay, so at least that would give you enough or sufficient comprehension of the cavity resonator. So this is the performance of cavity resonator. So as you can see, this is the input signal and this is the hollow dielectric field resonant cavity. Again, it would be much better if you will use low resistance material such as metal, specifically silver. Okay, so this is the input signal and the output signal. So this is the input spectrum. So as you can see, it goes like that, but the output would be specified at the specific frequency. Okay, so that's why it has a high quality factor. So this is what I'm trying to draw a while ago regarding the high quality factor. This is also one of the advantage of this resonator, because it gives a high quality factor which unachievable by the tunable circuit or a lamp circuit. So it can be used in microwave oscillator, just what I have said a while ago, amplifier, and also a bandpass filter. So this is also the reason why cavity resonator is not, or it's being enclosed compared to the rectangular wave, because the rectangular wave is a high pass filter. While the cavity resonator is a bandpass filter, which is clearly depicted from our body plot or the frequency response. Okay, so this one. A lot of formula which is also used in the latter slide that goes like this. Which is basically the same as Q or C over 2, which is this as the speed of light. Okay, if you also evaluate this one, it will also give you the same results. This velocity of light divided by 2. Okay, so let's have an example. So this is an example. So if you try to find the F101, which would be so 1, since our M, this one they fix for M and P, 1, 2 centimeter plus 1, 4 centimeter. When you try to put it in your calculator, it will give you a result of this one. So that's how you find this one. So at 8.38 gigahertz, above or below that would be attenuated, since as discussed, we have this kind of frequency response. Okay, now maybe you were asking, what is the reason for the high quality factor? So remember that this is approximately equal. So this is the FMNP that we've solved a while ago. So in our example, it is 8.38 gigahertz. So as you can see, it is a high value. This one, the basis of this would be this one. The quality factor is defined in terms of the ratio of the energy stored in the cavity volume to the energy dissipated in the cavity walls through conduction. So pay attention to the word conduction, because for an ideal cavity with perfectly conducting walls, no energy loss is incurred as a result, which Q is infinite. However, since this is an ideal value, it is expected that our delta F, this one, would have a very low value due to the reason that we have heat conduction and resistance, as discussed in previous slide, that there is an effect of the surface resistance of the wall used in rectangular wave, which is also same reasoning happen in this cavity resonator. So that's it. In this video, we discussed the rectangular waveguide as well as cavity resonator. Thank you for listening.